If there's one thing that Skaven are known for, it's having an endless swarm of rats pouring towards their enemy. And if you're collecting a Skaven army, then, well, you're going to want to do this. So in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to paint a clanrat in a really efficient way. Now, everything I'm going to show you will be useful for any Skaven infantry-sized figure. So whether you're doing Storm Vermin or Plague Monks, you're going to find something useful in this video. So let's get started. Whenever I'm painting a regiment or a squad, what I'll normally do is paint the entire unit in one go and set up a kind of production line. So I'll do all the base coats on all of them first, then all the shades on all of them. And this is a very efficient way of painting a unit. But for this tutorial, I'm going to focus on painting just one clanrat to show you exactly how to do it. But I do recommend you paint your entire unit at the same time. Now the first stage is to apply a base coat of Mournfang Brown across the entire miniature. And if you want to add a bit of variety to your unit, what you can do is substitute this colour with some other browns as you go along. So Rhinox Hide and Gorthor Brown are both great choices, but I'm just going to stick to Mournfang Brown for mine. So I'm going to apply this colour using my large brush because I'm looking to paint this over the entire miniature. So I'm going to put a good dollop of this paint on my palette, add a little bit of water to it just to thin the paint down. This will help it flow smoothly onto the model as I apply it. And, well, what I'm looking to do is just paint this everywhere on the miniature. So I'm not going to apply too much paint at once. I'm just going to be putting it on, well, like this. And this model you can see I've undercoated with Chaos Black Spray. And as you put this base coat on, you might find you can still see some of that undercoat through it. This isn't a problem. Just let this first coat dry, then apply a second one afterwards. If you apply multiple thin coats like this, then you'll keep all the details really sharp in the miniature. So you can see that by applying two thin coats of Mournfang Brown, I've got a good solid colour, and I've kept all the detail really sharp as well. And with that done, we're ready to start the next step, which is to paint the fur. Now to do this, I'm going to do a technique called dry brushing. And to do this, you need to get yourself a dry brush, and I've got a medium dry brush here, and some of the dry paint, and I'm using Tyrant Skull for this. And what you need to do is just get a little bit of it loaded on the end of your brush and get some tissue. And what you do is start working the paint into your brush. Now these dry brushes have stiffer bristles than normal, which is ideal for this technique to work. And what you're looking to do is to get a very small amount of this paint left on your brush. So you're looking for your brush to be kind of like that before you begin. And what you do is just get your model and very lightly just start flicking the brush back and forth across the model wherever you want to be fur. So I'm looking at the arms and the legs primarily here, but also some bits around the face too. And you'll see the paint catches on the raised areas and really picks out all that detail for you. And there you see with the dry brushing done, we've really picked out the texture of all the fur. Now the next step is to start base coating the skin, and the colour you want this time is Ratskin Flesh. And I'll be applying this using my standard brush because you need a bit more control over this colour than you did earlier on with the Mournfang Brown. So I'm going to use my palette once again to thin my paint down with a little bit of water. And I'm also going to use it to make sure I don't have too much paint on my brush and that the bristles come to a nice tip. So you can just twist your brush, drag it along like that, and this gives you lots of control. Because what you're looking to do here is to base coat this colour over all the areas of skin. So you're looking at the hands, the feet, the face and the tail as well. And on the areas like the hands where you can see the flesh meeting the fur, just let your paint be brought to points using the tip of your brush like that. This just helps with the transition of the fur to the skin. And with the Ratskin Flesh now applied, we've got a good base coat for all the skin. And we can move on to the next step, which is to start base coating the clothes. Now, I'm going to be using two colours for doing this. I've got both Khorne Red and Abaddon Black. And what I'm going to do is paint different layers of the clothing using both of these colours. What I recommend you do on your unit is mix these two up across the entire unit, because this will give the appearance of a rabble whilst keeping the colour scheme consistent overall. So I'm going to start with Khorne Red, which I'm applying with my standard brush once again. And as I say, I'm just going to pick a layer of clothing and paint the whole area using this colour. So thin the paint down with a little bit of water again, make sure there's not too much on the brush. And I'm going to start with the lower layer around here, just next to his armour on his back. So you just need to apply the base coat as evenly as you can, just being careful of the other colours. Once you've picked out some of the clothes with red, do the same with Abaddon Black on other areas. And if you wanted to, you could even do some of the shields like this as well. And with the Abaddon Black applied, the clothes are now done. And, well, there's now just a few more details to do, smaller details, which I'm going to base coat in the same way that I've been doing all the other colours so far. Now, these are going to be, first of all, the wood and any leather straps, which I'm doing with Dryad Bark. Then after that, I'm going to start painting the metallics, first with Leadbelcher, and then with Balthasar Gold. And finally, I'm going to start painting the teeth and the claws using Zandri Dust. So starting out with the Dryad Bark, I'm going to be using my standard brush for this stage. And, well, this is a case of base coating all the areas that you can see as wood, and also any leather straps you have too. So you're just looking to get a good even base colour. So I'll start with a shield. You see, just like that. Then start base coating the metallic areas, starting with Leadbelcher. And like with the clothes, it's really up to you which bits exactly you pick out with this colour. I'm going to go for the sword blade and also his body armour. Then paint all the remaining metallic areas using Balthasar Gold. Now I'm tending to paint smaller areas with this, so I've switched to using a fine detail brush now. And then the final areas to base coat are the teeth and the claws, and do these with Zandri Dust and your fine detail brush. So with the Zandri Dust now applied, we've finished putting on all of the base colours. And well, at this stage, it's a good idea just to take a minute, just have a once over on your model to make sure that all the colours are neat. Because now we're going to move on to the second phase, really, of painting the miniature. And that is to apply a shade across the entire model. Now, the colour you need for this is Agrax Earthshade, and I'll be applying this using my wash brush, because I'm going to be putting on quite a lot at once here. So get a good dollop of this on your palette. And well, you're looking to, as I say, just paint this all over your model. So I'm going to start up here around the face, and as you're applying this, you want to make sure you really work it into all the details, because you'll see them immediately start to pop out, especially around the face. So you want to go all over your miniature here, but keep an eye on it as it dries to make sure you've not put on too much, because if the shade starts blobbing up towards the bottom of the model, there's definitely too much on it, in which case you can use your brush like a sponge just to remove the excess. Now once you've applied this all over your model, give it plenty of time to dry. About 30 to 40 minutes should be good. I've given the shade about half an hour to dry, and you can see it's made a massive difference to the model. It's really given loads of depth to it. And well, all that remains to do to the model now is to start layering and highlighting it. So the first area I'm going to do this to is the most prominent on Skaven, which is the skin. And for this, the colour you need is Cadian Fleshtone, which I'm going to be applying using my detail brush. And well, with these stages, you need to be much more in control of what you're doing than when we were base coating. So I'm going to use my palette to make sure I get that really good tip on my brush. So you don't need very much paint on your brush at all. About that should be fine. And what you're looking to do is to paint this over most of the skin, but leaving the deeper areas with the darker colour showing. So if I start on the face, for example, I'm just going to work around his mouth here. And you can see where the shade's settled in that little dip there. I'm going to skip that and pick up the painting on the other side of it, like that. And doing this will really define all these features on your model. So you need to do this on all the skin, and well, don't forget, when you're doing areas like the hands and the feet, as the skin gets to where all the fur is, do exactly like with the base coat and just paint up to little points like that for the transition to the fur. And you can see there what a big difference the Cadian flesh tones made to the skin. And you could leave it here if you wanted to, but because the skin's such a prominent feature on Skaven, I want to go a little bit further on it. And if you want to do the same, what you need to do now is add a highlight of Kislev Flesh. And for this, you'll need your fine detail brush. And well, what you're looking to do here is paint, well, thin lines, really. So I'm going to be using my palette to make sure I've got that really good tip on the brush, and the paint's thinned down again so that it will flow easily. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to look for all the sharper details on the skin. So on the face, for example, I'll be doing a little bit of this on the nose, just following this this edge, really, just along there. And on the ear as well, I'm just going to go around the top of it there on that sharper edge, and on the bottom of the mouth too. Now, there's a couple of other areas around the body that I'll need to do the same thing on. So I'm going to be doing this on the, on the hands. I'll just be going down the fingers, just along there like that. And it'll be the same on the feet, and also a couple of bits like this on the tail as well. And there we go. You see, by highlighting the flesh, we've really given it lots of definition and made all those details pop out. And well, the next thing to highlight is going to be the clothes. And for this, I've got two colours. I've got Wazdakka Red and also Eshin Grey. And I'm going to be starting out with the Wazdakka Red and my fine detail brush. And this is to highlight all the red parts of the clothing. So this will vary a little bit depending on how you've painted the, or what parts you painted red on yours. But the important thing here is to thin your paint, just like when we're highlighting the skin, and to get that good tip on your brush. And what you're looking to do on the clothing is look for where the shade has settled, and look for the sharp edges next to it. So around here, for example, I'm just going to paint a red line following along that edge there, and same along there. So I just need to do this around all the red now as well, and also along the bottom of the clothing, just along there like that. And then do exactly the same on the black cloth using Eshin Grey. And with those highlights applied, the clothes are now done. So the next thing that we're going to paint is the shield, and there's quite a lot of wood grain on this, so I'm going to dry brush it. And for this you need Tyrant Skull and your medium dry brush once again. And this is going to be like early on when we dry brush the fur, only this time I'm going to be using much less paint. So I'm really going to make sure I get rid of most of it on the tissue this time. And I'm going to very lightly start dry brushing this across the length of the wood grain. So I'm going to start going this way very lightly, just being careful of all of the details around it. You really don't need very much here. And with that dry brush done, the wood grain is now finished, and we can start doing the next part, which is to highlight all the metallic areas. Now for this, the colour you need is Runefang Steel, and using your fine detail brush, what we're going to do here is highlight all the silver parts and all the brass parts too. So you need to thin your paint once again, like we were doing with the clothes really, because we're going to be highlighting in the same kind of way, going around all the sharpest parts. So if I start on the sword here, you can see how the shade's settled either side of this raised bit here. I'm just going to paint this colour just along those parts like that. And this will help really define all these shapes. Now on some parts you can actually use the side of your brush instead, where it's like a much sharper angle, like on the edge of the sword here. You can just use the side of your brush to run along it, and this way you get a neat straight line very easily. So you need to do this on all the silver parts now, and on all the brass parts too. Our clanrat's nearly done now. In fact, there's just a few final little details left to do, and for these you only need two more colours. First we're going to paint the teeth and the claws using Ushabti Bone, then after that we're going to paint the eyes using Evil Sun Scarlet. So starting out with the Ushabti Bone for the teeth and the claws, I'm using my fine detail brush, and well, for this process you just need to be as neat as you can be. So I'm going to thin the paint down with a little bit of water again, get that really good tip in the brush. You see you don't need much paint at all. And then I'm just going to keep my hands as steady as possible just to paint these details. So starting with the teeth here, I'm going to go on either side to highlight the two front teeth there. You can see I'm just adding a small amount of paint to do that, and then just pick out the other ones with a little bit, and you do exactly the same on the claws. And finally, paint the eyes with Evil Sun Scarlet and a fine detail brush, and for this you just need to keep your hands as steady as possible and just apply a small dot to the eye just like that. Then after you've done this on all of your miniatures, all you've got to do is base them and you're finished. And there he is, the clanrat is now complete, and I'm really happy with the finished result, but just imagine how much more awesome it would be to have dozens of these swarming towards your enemy. So remember, whenever you're painting a unit, a really good method to paint them is to set up a kind of production line. So I'll start with one base coat and do it on all of them, and then move on to the next one. This is a really efficient way to paint a unit, and it also keeps all the models consistent with each other. Now with Skaven, a great start for them is to start out by painting the fur, because you can dry brush this, and dry brushing can be a bit messy, so if you do it first, you can neaten up then as you add more base colours. Also, a really good way to paint units is to apply as many base colours as you can, then shade them all in one go with one shade. So Agrax Earthshade worked really well for this, but also normal oil can be a good choice too. And finally, well, when you start doing your highlights, remember to be as neat as you can, because, well, especially with the most prominent colours like the skin and things. And the neater you are, the better the final result's going to be. Now, this video has been lots of fun to make, and I really hope you guys enjoy painting your models. So, we'll see you soon with some more tutorials.